My name is Anastasia Chavez, and I'm just finishing my first year as a tenure track assistant professor at St. Mary's College of California. Yeah, this is an interesting question for me because I definitely feel like I wasn't the kid that you would naturally think is a born mathematician. I didn't think I liked math. I didn't do things that felt mathematical, but I want to believe that later in life, I realized that the things I was into had a sense of science or math or discovery, kind of bred into it. So I really liked puzzles. I really enjoyed playing games that required some kind of inquisitive piece to it, riddles, figuring something out. And it wasn't until probably like fifth grade is the first time when I remember having a moment in class when we were doing math, and I really enjoyed it. And I said, "I'm already done, and I'm ready to move on." And then my teacher was like, "Well, that's nice for you, but we haven't finished, so you're gonna have to wait." And I think that's probably one of the first memories I had of being like, maybe I'm good at it and I'm kind of fast. I don't know. That didn't last very long. I wanted to be a mathematician probably not until my master's degree, which sounds really late, but I would say that as I was going through my academic experience, I typically was just following the path laid before me. Wasn't until I was in the master's program at San Francisco State University and then starting a family that I really started to think about what does the future look like for me and where is a place that I could have a meaningful impact. And having kids, and so I have two kids that now identify as non-binary and trans male. So they were born female sex. And so growing up at that stage, I was really, what's the word I'm looking for? Motivated by having two, what I call daughters, and really thinking about how can I support women in mathematics? How can I support diversity, at all different levels? But at that moment, it was really like I'm a mother to two daughters and I want to make a difference and be a role model for them. And so it really felt like having that PhD was kind of the ticket to finally having a voice in a arena that I felt needed a lot of change. And then I was doing research with Dr. Matt Beck at San Francisco State, and that was really eye-opening. And he was an incredible mentor. And so I think having a positive research experience with this other motivation to want to really try to make a difference. Was the moment when I felt like, okay, I want to stay in mathematics. I want to pursue this professor career, I guess. And it always felt tenuous. Like it really felt like I'm doing something that I wanted to do and maybe that I was sort of meant to do. I'm not so sure anymore. But all the while, it was challenging and difficult. And I had many, many opportunities to stop and ask myself, is this really what I want to do? I kind of have to call myself a mathematician because I do all the things a mathematician does. On the other side, it's like, I don't know that I really like to be called that because it includes me in a community that has particular history or values that I don't necessarily align with. So this has definitely always been a tricky question for me because I do what people call combinatorics. What I like to do is think about interesting objects that you can try to kind of understand the inherent structure of. And often there's a lot of interesting counting that pops up. And so not only that, like you don't necessarily just ask questions of how many of this thing are there just because that's an interesting question, but also because that actually gives you some information about the object itself or sort of in the area of other objects that it lives that helps to distinguish it from other things. And so that's one kind of aspect to better understand these types of mathematical objects. And because they get observed from this perspective, then they are called combinatorial objects. And so if I were to say a combinatorial object is a matroid, for example, partly that helps to put it into that particular field, but it also gives you a sense that there is some inherent structure about this particular mathematical object that people like to count things of, or, you know, use that as a way to better understand it in a fundamental sort of way. Some of the struggles I've dealt with, I would say, are fairly common. So personal struggles around my own abilities. Am I, you know, good enough at this? Will I continue to be good enough? So I'd say just, you know, trying to get out of my own way. Also having a family while I was in my master's program, and then raising kids while I was finishing grad school. I wouldn't say that, you know, it's just life, but it makes things difficult. So that was definitely challenging. And then the other parts are just having to go up against discouragement. I was thinking about how, you know, people are, some people don't support affirmative action. So like, how do we, you know, help level the playing field for people to have access to education? And my experience is that even if maybe I wasn't a student at UC Berkeley because of affirmative action, I kind of like it was actively affirmed to me that I didn't belong there. And I'd say that was one of the biggest struggles that I had to deal with. And it's not an overcome situation. It's just, you know, don't succumb to it. And so having several people throughout my years tell me it's not worth your time, they made a mistake, they're taking a big chance on you, I know you could do great things, but Berkeley's not the place. And just having to, you know, push through that until there was somebody or groups of people, or, you know, even myself just being like, I'm not going to listen to it. I'm just going to keep going until I'm finished. And that's kind of the only way to get there. I'd say I guess I have several things that I feel proud of accomplishing. Maybe the first that comes up is my kids. They're incredible people, and I probably don't tell them enough, but they're really fantastic, and they've dealt with a lot of stuff already in the few years, you know, that they've been here on this earth. And they continue to just keep teaching my husband and I so much about the world and about how to be better people. There are some moments where they even say to me, "You're a really cool mom," or "Thank you for all you do." And maybe I've only heard that like 3 times in my life, but the moments when I hear it, I'm like, okay, I've done something good here. Absolutely, earning my PhD is also another huge accomplishment. Not that I ever didn't think I couldn't do it, but I feel like it was one of those goals where I wasn't really sure if it's what I wanted. Throughout the PhD experience, it was really, really challenging. And so when I got to walk that day and both of my kids walked on stage, I had printed out little diplomas for them, you know, wrapped them up. And I asked my advisor, so I was co-advised by Federico Ardila and Lauren Williams. So I handed them each one. I was like, "Do you mind giving this to my kids, you know, when you hood me?" And so that was super sweet. And all my family, I think I took up half the auditorium with my family there. It was definitely a big, big deal. And I'd say even maybe as a smaller accomplishment this semester or term, I had several students say to me things like, "I enjoy doing math again," or "I really felt like I had someone who cared about me." And I think that for me as an educator and somebody who is really working towards trying to shift the culture around how we support students in math and helping them to build more of a mathematical identity that feels positive, that was a really, really sweet accomplishments. I went to the San Rosa Junior College right out of high school, and from there transferred to San Francisco State. And when I was at the JC, I had my first calculus teacher there, Kirby Bunis, who was like, "You're really good at this. You should be my TA. Make sure you keep going." And that was probably the first time I remember somebody saying, "You're really good at math. Why don't you stick this out?" And then once I got to SF State, David Ellis was a really great mentor. He helped me secure a lot of funding that basically made me have no debt. Like, I have very little debt because of him. And then absolutely Matt Beck, when I was doing my master's program there, worked with him on my master's thesis, really wonderful guy. And one of the things that I still hold sort of close to me that he said to me once was something like, we don't have a career and try to figure out how to fit life into it. It's more like you have your life and then you try to figure out how your career fits into it. And so it was a really good, you know, reframing. And at the time I was, you know, having my youngest child and I was pregnant. So he saw me through that whole transition. And it really was just kind of a great acknowledgement. And then once I got to UC Berkeley, Federico Ardila, Lauren Williams were fantastic advisors, mentors. They both kind of, it was like parents where it's like one, you know, it has one thing they offer you and the other one has something else they offer you. They both offered more or less all the same great things you would want. And then now I'll just say being at St. Mary's College, Ellen Viamet, who's our current chair of the math department, has been amazing. Like, I've known Ellen for a number of years, just sort of as acquaintances, but she's really been an incredible, I mean, I should say several other people, but she, as a chair of a math department in particular, she's been really wonderful. One thing that comes to mind, which is kind of captures all of the ideas that I would say, when I was a kid, I played baseball and my dad was my coach and all this stuff. And he would often have this phrase, don't sweat the small stuff and everything is small. Nothing is worth the pain and effort that you think you need to get, you know, like nothing is that important. The more life I live, the easier it is perhaps to practice that because you just have the experience to remind you that, oh yeah, I got through that too. I can get through this.